click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to continue the last video, that is problems based on derivatives. We have first problem: if f of x is equal to or y is equal to e raised to 7x into cos 7x, find dy by dx. Now here two functions are getting multiplied, so we will find the derivative of these functions using UV rule. But these two functions are composite functions. Now what are composite functions? If I say the function e raised to x, this is a standard function, but if I replace x by any another function like say e raised to 2x or e raised to sin x, that function becomes a composite function. To find the derivative of this function, we are going to use UV rule. Let us start with that UV rule. Y is equal to e raised to 7x into cos 7x. We'll write differentiating above function with respect to x. So the derivative of y with respect to x will be written as dy by dx, and the right hand side will be solved using UV rule. So u as it is, derivative of v plus v as it is, derivative of u. How to find the derivative of composite function? Let us see. E raised to 7x as it is. To find the derivative of cos 7x, we'll compare this function with the standard function. What is standard function? That is derivative of cos x. So derivative of cos x, we have minus sin x. Then the derivative of cos 7x will give you minus sin 7x. Then what is the change? We'll just take a derivative of the function that is replacing x. In this case, x is replaced by 7x. So we will multiply that part of 7x. Derivative of cos 7x was minus sin 7x. X is replaced by 7x. We multiplied that part by derivative of 7x. U into derivative of v is ready. Plus v as it is, cos 7x into derivative of e raised to 7x. Derivative of e raised to x, it is e raised to x. Then derivative of e raised to 7x will be e raised to 7x. In this case, x is replaced by 7x. Then we'll multiply the derivative of 7x again. This is nothing but chain rule. It is also called as chain rule. Then the next step can be followed by e raised to 7x into minus sin 7x. Derivative of 7x, we have 7 as a constant, and derivative of x will be 1, plus cos 7x into e raised to 7x. Again, derivative of 7x, we have 7. Now let us see the next step. So we have dy by dx as e raised to 7x into minus sin 7x into 7 plus cos 7x into e raised to 7x into 7. To find the final answer, we can take e raised to 7x into 7 as common part from both these terms. So taking that part common as e raised to 7x into 7, we have minus sin 7x plus cos 7x. So this is the derivative of the given function. Now let us start with problem number 5. In problem number 5, we have find derivative of x sin inverse x. So you can consider the given function as y is equal to x into sin inverse x. Again, we have two functions which are getting multiplied. To find the derivative of this function, we'll use UV rule. Differentiating above function with respect to x. So derivative of y with respect to x will give you dy by dx. We have u as x and v as sin inverse x. U as it is, derivative of v plus v as it is, derivative of u. Now these are not the composite functions, these are the standard functions. So we have directly the formulas. Let us start. X into derivative of sin inverse x. Now derivative of sin inverse x is given by 1 upon under root 1 minus x square plus sin inverse x into derivative of x is 1. So the final answer can be written as dy by dx is equal to x upon under root 1 minus x square plus sin inverse x into 1 will give you sin inverse x. So this is the derivative of the given function. In problem number 6, we have find dy by dx if y is equal to sec x into tan x. Again, we have two functions which are getting multiplied. So whenever there are any two functions which are multiplied, we can directly use the UV rule. Y is equal to sec x into tan x. Differentiating above function with respect to x. So derivative of y with respect to x will be dy by dx. Now let us arrange the right hand side in the form of uv. U as it is, derivative of, it means d by dx of v, followed by plus v as it is, that is tan x, into derivative of u. Now the format is ready. Let us start differentiating. Sec x into derivative of tan x, we have sec square x plus tan x, and derivative of sec x is given as sec x into tan x. The final answer dy by dx can be written as sec into sec square x, we have sec cube x plus we have tan into tan, that is tan square x into sec x. So this is the derivative of the given function y is equal to sec x plus sec x into tan x. I hope you have understood this video. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe Ekeeda.